our President, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, Union Minister of Commerce and Industry, Union Minister of Communications, Ministers, Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. A very warm welcome to all our dignitaries and our illustrious audience to this evening's inaugural function. It is a privilege for the Confederation of Indian Industry to partner the Global Exhibition on Services 2017. I'd like to extend my warm thanks to our President for hosting us at the President's Estate and for gracing the inaugural ceremony. Your support for two consecutive editions of GES has placed it on a very strong pedestal. Services have long been an engine of growth, accounting for over 60% of GDP in our country, and it accounts also for the great bulk of employment creation. GES 2017 displays the potential in so many different sectors. As the Commerce and Industry Minister mentioned earlier today, we now cover over 20 different sectors, each with great potential. My own favorites are tourism, healthcare, and education. Each provides a massive opportunity, an opportunity for Indian and global firms to serve India, and an opportunity for Indian and global firms to serve the world from India. In the process, we can create millions of attractive jobs in India and around the world. We need to invest in skills in a substantial way to address each sector, and we need to invest in the institutions that will form those connections that make all of this happen. GES provides a great platform for firm to meet firm. We have over 500 exhibitors from over 70 countries. I hope that you would go away with the connections that can realize this potential and wish you a most productive few days here in Delhi. Once again, I'd like to end by thanking our President for hosting us this evening. Thank you.
Honorable Shri Pranab Mukherjee, President of India. Honorable Srimati Nirmala Sitharaman, Minister for Commerce and Industry. Honorable Shri Manoj Sinha, Minister for Communications. Shri Patwari, Minister for Transport, Commerce and Industry, Government of Assam. Shri Pachauri, Minister for MSME and Export Promotion, Government of Uttar Pradesh. Distinguished ministers and delegates from participating countries and our 24 state partners, Dr. Naushad Forbes, President CII, Dr. Trehan, Chairman SEPC, Excellencies, representatives of industry, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Government of India and the Department of Commerce, may I extend a very warm welcome to the Global Exhibition of Services 2017. The Honorable President of India has been our guide and mentor to the entire GES process, and his leadership has been central to the success of this mega event. It is therefore an honor for I and the Department of Commerce to welcome him and seek his guidance again today. Srimati Nirmala Sitharaman has led the global exhibition from the front, and her continued leadership role has added immense strength and value to the efforts of the department to promote international trade in services. May I also offer a very warm welcome to our honored guests from overseas who have demonstrated strong interest in intensifying the services engagement and partnership with India and the world to promote the international trade in services. We welcome this time the very robust participation by 24 state governments in this event, which is fairly unprecedented for this event. The Indian services sector has evolved as a leading sector in the Indian economy with a significant contribution to income, trade, investment, and of course, employment. By leveraging our demographic dividend, India has the potential to emerge as a global leader in multiple services verticals. Recognizing that services trade is a key growth driver globally, the department, in association with CII and the Services Export Promotion Council, has conceptualized this dedicated platform for building the visibility of the services economy. The GES is a flagship platform and an enabler of the services basket for the world and for India. It was a special honor that the first GES was inaugurated by the Honorable Prime Minister in 2015. The Prime Minister stressed that GES could capture significant global services value and build India's position as a knowledge hub. The Honorable President of India honored us with his presence at the second edition of GES last year, and his continued commitment to the effort is strengthened by his August participation today, which gives us strength and encouragement. With the success of GES 2015 and 16, GES 2017 strives to raise the bar in terms of widening the outreach to the world and expanding the sectoral coverage. This edition of GES has participation of 73 countries, including developing, advanced, and emerging economies from all regions of the world. This affirms the high importance accorded by the world to fostering a conducive global services trade environment. This year, the exhibition embraces 20 vital sectors showcasing India's core competencies, from banking and financial services to retail, tourism, hospitality, media, entertainment, IT, and telecom. This year, we are pleased to add next generation cities, sports, services, space, and startups as some of the new categories which we saw as we walked through the exhibition this morning. This year, we have introduced a new element of talk and tell, wherein we have invited some prominent celebrities to speak on diverse services-related issues. We are happy to share that celebrity speakers like Shri Shri Ravi Shankar, Shilpa Shetty, Amish Tripathi, Ramesh Sippy, Sudhir Mishra, and Craig McDermott would be sharing their thoughts with us in their respective areas of expertise. The GES has many new elements this year, adding to the holistic business experience. The incredible India Heart offers a diverse cuisine, culture, and handicraft show. The animation and post-production film festival will perhaps attract tremendous consumer interest. A particular focus for the GES is related to knowledge expansion and interchange through 32 specific knowledge sessions that will explore new modes of international partnership. Additionally, over 3,500 business-to-business meetings have been scheduled, which will open new business avenues over the next 2 days for our stakeholders. In accordance with the Government of India's endeavor to nurture new growth opportunities, including through stronger international engagement, GES converges multiple vectors aimed at driving momentum in a sector that is of increasing centrality to the global economy. As a strong player in the services economy, India wishes to work with the world on creating a facilitative and attractive climate for global trade in services. The GES, as one of the few such platforms in the world for bringing together businesses engaged in services, would continue to evolve as a powerful destination for driving global engagement in the sector. Once again, I welcome you all to this convention and thank you for your participation.
Good evening, Honorable President of India, the Honorable Ministers on the dais, and all the dignitaries, functionaries of CII and the Government of India. So I here wear several hats as far as services exports is concerned, because I chair the Services Export Promotion Council. Also, I chair the Health Sector Skill Council. So I'd like to speak to you basically expressing the two tandem strengths India has. And for our own need, we have developed some models which we feel are quite attractive and quite applicable to the dignitaries who have traveled from all over the world to see how India has evolved its strength in not only in IT, in artificial intelligence, cloud computing and things like that, but also in one, developing the models of healthcare which will be able to, in the coming years, provide healthcare to every man standing, woman standing and the child standing in our, on our earth, part of India I mean, and then hook them up sequentially from primary healthcare to secondary to tertiary healthcare. This credit of course goes to the 2 years of intensive policy decisions that have been cleared and made it possible for us to bring the highest end of healthcare to India, where we can compete with the best in the world. At the same time, the cost is 1/10 of what it costs in the best of the places in around the universe. So the basically strength that we are projecting as a nation is, one, we welcome people who do access healthcare at a level which is not available today in their countries, and we can offer them that kind of care which may be available anywhere in the world or even better at 1/10 the cost. Secondly, we have a very vibrant hospitality and travel agency sector which is now coming together with the healthcare sector to provide solutions for connectivity, for ease of travel, for ease of accessing visas, for then connecting directly into the hospitals so that the patients who are seeking healthcare and are in feeble or vulnerable state will not have to experience any vagaries of the environment, but come straight to the hospital, be taken care of and put back on at the airport so that they can safely return to their countries. So much for the strengths of healthcare that we have developed. But more importantly, the idea is not only to welcome people who need the services today, but to assist the countries that want to get associated with India in helping them develop their healthcare sector, because we have been at it for over 25 years in a very organized fashion. And I, in my travels around this region, there are many, many countries who will be able to access training, models of healthcare, in addition to accessing healthcare from us. And I think that I would today give that open offer that we will be very happy to assist any individual, any community, any state or country which would like to access our ability to develop healthcare around this region so that we can give the much needed succor. On the other hand, skills is another big thing that we have, the current government has laid a lot of stress on, and we have developed some of the finest simulation centers for developing skills and upgrading skills and sidestepping skills in the last several years. And I think, again, I could make a pitch that in case any one of you would like to associate or access healthcare skill sector council or other councils in skilling, that would be another good engagement for India to have with our neighbors and extended neighbors. With that, I thank you for this opportunity to share our part of the segment of this export promotion, and also welcome, take this opportunity again to welcome all the delegates who are here and in the coming days to be able to share the whole experience with you. Thank you very much.
Bharat ke Mahamahim Rashtrapati Sammananiya Pranab Mukherjee ji, Vanijya aur Udyog Rajya Mantri Swatantra Prabhar Sammananiya Nirmala Sitaraman ji, Manch par upasthit sabhi Uttar Pradesh ke hamare मंत्री श्री सदेव पचौरी जी, आसाम के सम्माननीय मंत्री जी, मंच पर उपस्थित सभी सम्मानित महानुभाव, सभागार में उपस्थित विभिन्न देशों के सम्मानित मंत्रीगण, विशिष्ट अतिथिगण, देवी और सज्जनों, यह मेरे लिए अत्यंत गौरव का विषय है कि आज मुझे ग्लोबल एग्जीबिशन ऑन सर्विसेज पर माई स्टैम्प जारी करने के लिए उपस्थित होना पड़ा है। ये निश्चित रूप से हमारे लिए प्रसन्नता का विषय है। भारतीय डाक टिकटों की निजीकृत सीट्स का नाम माई स्टैम्प है। चुने हुए माई स्टैम्प विषय के साथ ग्राहक और संस्थानों के लोग कलाकृतियों, विरासत भवनों, प्रसिद्ध पर्यटन स्थलों, ऐतिहासिक शहरों, वन्य जीव तथा अन्य जानवरों और पक्षियों आदि की तस्वीरें मुद्रित करके निजीकृत माई स्टैम्प प्राप्त किया जाता है। कस्टमाइज्ड माई स्टैम्प डाक टिकटों की एक निजी सीट है जिसमें कॉरपोरेट संगठन और संस्थान भारतीय डाक से मुद्रित अपनी अनुकूलित सीट प्राप्त कर सकते हैं। इन कस्टमाइज थीम्ड स्टैम्प के साथ संगठन अपने लोगों के मुद्रण और उनके संगठन संस्थान की छवियों या डाक टिकट के साथ मुद्रित अपने कर्मचारी के फोटो का चयन भी कर सकते हैं। स्वनिर्धारित माई स्टैम्प सीट्स की छपाई दिसंबर 2015 से शुरू की गई है। अपनी स्थापना के बाद से ही स्वनिर्धारित माई स्टैम्प की लोकप्रियता दिन प्रतिदिन बढ़ती जा रही है। ये हमारे विभाग के लिए प्रसन्नता की बात है कि ग्लोबल एग्जीबिशन ऑन सर्विसेज पर आज एक माई स्टैम्प हम जारी कर रहे हैं और ये भारत से बाहर के लिए ली जाने वाली सेवाओं पर विशेष ध्यान देने और बड़ी संख्या में प्रतिभागी कंपनियों के साथ सेवा क्षेत्र में क्षमताओं के प्रदर्शन का एक फ्लैगशिप मंच है। यह कार्यक्रम वाणिज्य एवं उद्योग मंत्रालय, भारत सरकार, सेवा निर्यात संवर्धन परिषद और भारतीय उद्योग परिसंघ द्वारा सेवाओं में अंतर्राष्ट्रीय व्यापार का विस्तार और बड़े स्तर पर वैश्विक हित के सृजन तथा प्रतिवर्ष भागीदारी के साथ वार्षिक आधार पर आयोजित किया जाता है। भारत की अर्थव्यवस्था और व्यापार में सेवाओं के बहुआयामी योगदान के लिए जीएस एक सुसंगत और व्यापक नीतिगत ढांचे के भीतर एक सेवा आधारित विकास रणनीति के डिज़ाइन एवं कार्यान्वयन के लिए अति आवश्यक मंच प्रदान करता है तथा अन्य नीतिगत क्षेत्रों में सामंजस्य तथा समग्र राष्ट्रीय विकास के उद्देश्यों को सुनिश्चित करता है। मुझे लगता है कि 3 वर्ष हुए हैं, 15 में प्रधानमंत्री जी ने, 16 में महामहिम राष्ट्रपति जी ने इसका उद्घाटन किया था और पुनः आज राष्ट्रपति भवन में हम लोग उपस्थित हैं। मैं माननीय राष्ट्रपति जी को ग्लोबल एग्जीबिशन ऑन सर्विसेज पर माई स्टैम्प जारी करने हेतु आमंत्रित करूंगा थोड़ी देर बाद। ये मेरे लिए अत्यंत गौरव और प्रसन्नता का विषय है। मुझे लगता है कि जब अच्छा सीरियल चले तो विज्ञापन थोड़ी देर का ठीक है, तो विज्ञापन के तौर पर ही डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पोस्ट की भूमिका थी जिसको मैंने समाप्त किया है। अब असली विज्ञापन निर्मला सीतारमण जी दिखाएंगी। धन्यवाद।
नमस्कार। मोस्ट रिस्पेक्टेड प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया, मिनिस्टर इन द काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स अलोंग विद मी श्री मनोज सिन्हा जी, मिनिस्टर फ्रॉम उत्तर प्रदेश श्री पचौरी जी, मिनिस्टर फ्रॉम असम पटवारी जी, डॉक्टर त्रेहान, डॉक्टर नौशाद फोर्ब्स ऑफ द CII, कॉमर्स सेक्रेटरी एंड CII's डायरेक्टर जनरल चंद्रजीत बैनर्जी, ministers who have come from abroad, 6 of them, we are very happy to receive you. 73 country participants who have come from various parts of the world, excellencies, ambassadors, several ministerial colleagues, and ladies and gentlemen, I'm immensely honored to be here today and greatly satisfied, and I place my gratitude to the Rashtrapati, who has, for the second year consecutive, agreed to inaugurate the Global Exhibition of Services. I say this in every meeting in his presence, that his guidance for the Commerce Ministry comes from straight from his heart, because he's mentioned it several times to me, that if any ministry has always kept him riveted, it is commerce. And therefore, each time we have approached the respected President of India, he has unhesitatingly guided us, supported us, and in a function of this global level. Today, he's not only just inaugurating, but has been gracious enough to host us in the Rashtrapati Bhavan premises. So I'm very grateful, and I put it on record, most respected Rashtrapati ji, for your kind hospitality that you are extending to us. Sorry. The third edition of the Global Exhibition on Services is a proud occasion when India showcases its strength in the services sector. As all of you all know, if anything, there is a more than 53% contribution of the services sector to India's gross value addition. Whilst comparatively, if you look at it, the manufacturing sector does 16.6%. So the role that the service sector has in the Indian economy need not be overemphasized. It is a sector in which we want to give a lot of attention. The first edition of the Global Exhibition of Services had about 7 focus areas. The second one had about 10, and today we are talking about 20 focus areas in service sector, and the Service Export Promotion Council is headed by no less than Dr. Naresh Threghan himself, who's a pioneer in health sector. The segment or the portion of the global exhibition, global services trade that India commands is about 3.3%, whereas it has scope for expansion, scope for more, and each edition of this Global Exhibition on Services has only served that purpose. Just for the information of those august present audience today, the first and the second edition actually helped us in signing MOUs with countries like Afghanistan, Seychelles, and also with the two other countries for and Bangladesh for health service related service share. Similarly, in railways, the Minister of State for Railways is here. We have had an agreement signed with Australia. In IT, we have had agreements signed with countries like Japan and Singapore. So these are outcomes of the Global Exhibition on Services. And this year too, with 550 exhibitors here in the Global Exhibition on Services, 450 of it are Indian exhibitors and 100 who have come from abroad, we expect to have the similar kind of sharing of information and benefiting each other from the kind of strength that India wishes to showcase. Without taking more of your time, I wish to hear the Rashtrapati giving us further direction on how best Global Exhibition on Services year after year can be a very useful platform for global thought process on services, which have now become, particularly in the era of Industrial Revolution 4.0, which has become a very serious component even for manufacturing sector. With those words, I welcome all of you all and look forward to the Rashtrapati's few words of suggestion for us. Thank you.
Thank you, President of India. Thank you, Honorable Minister.
Good evening, Srimati Nirmala Sitaraman, Minister, Commerce and Industry, Government of India, Sri Manoj Sinha, Minister, Communication, Government of India, Sri Chandramohan Patwari, Minister, Government of Assam, Sri Satyadev Pachauri, Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Dr. Naused Fawaz, President CII, Dr. Naresh Trehan, Chairman ACPC, Srimati Rita Teuthia, Commerce Secretary, Sri Chandrajit Banerjee, DGCII, distinguished guests, excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed a privilege for me to be present at the inaugural session of third global exhibition on services. I compliment the Ministry of Commerce under its dynamic leadership of Minister Srimati Sitaraman, Confederation of Indian Industries and Commerce, CII, Services Export Promotion Council, for developing a very strong business platform aimed at deepening engagement of the international community in the global services trade and export domain. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, service trade is increasingly viewed as an instrument to create jobs, drive national growth, and foster exchange of ideas, knowledge, and technology. The services sector also contributes significantly to trade in goods, including through supply chains and e-commerce. At a time when global merchandise trade is slowing down, trade in services can bring new benefits to the global economy, even as technology, connectivity, and knowledge drive its growth. In this respect, India enjoys a special role. A country which can place 104 satellites in space from a single launch vehicle, provide successful medical surgeries at a fraction of the cost in advanced countries, win global awards for creativity in advertising, and emerge as the largest film producer in the world, has the potential to offer immense value to international services consumers across the spectrum of areas. The services sector contributed the lion's share of India's GDP and represents its fastest growing sector, with an estimated growth of 7.1% in 2016-17. While India has emerged as the fastest growing large economy in the world, the services sector outpaces its growth rate and has been its key growth driver. India's share in global service exports has increased to 3.3% in 2015. Our service sectors are helping global businesses build their productivity and competitiveness, and are supporting jobs across the world. It's noteworthy that the pattern of India's services exports is somewhat different from the global profile of services export, reflecting its inherent advantages in knowledge-based subsectors. While travel and transport services account for half of the world's total services exports of almost $5 trillion, India's overseas services engaged is dominated by ICT and other business services, which constitute about 2/3 of its total service exports. Regarding India's services imports, it is transport, other business services, and travel that are most in demand, with financial services and payments for intellectual property also contributing significantly. The composition of imports indicates India's growing aspiration to leverage services from overseas for its growth and development, and also points to its strength as a growing market for the world. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, the government has recently initiated a range of the key developmental campaigns aimed at unleashing new growth vectors that are further driving India's services subsectors. Make in India program targets the creation of an advanced manufacturing base increasingly built on embedded services such as research and development and design, retail and marketing, and logistics. The Digital India Initiative serves to connect all remote corners of the country through efficient digital infrastructure, while also increasing and manufacturing of electronics and offering key public services online. With a digital infrastructure in place, technology will reach down to the farthest hamlets, placing markets at the fingertips of the citizens and driving services growth. Startup India, Skill India initiative enhance the capabilities of our youth for livelihood opportunities, both as job providers and job seekers in the services markets. The Jan Dhan Yojana for financial inclusion and the strong push to fintech people less use of cash in the economy are shaping a new services dimension in the country and boosting sectors such as banking and finance, cyber security, and e-commerce. Distinguished participants, and I am happy to note that Global Exhibition on Services embraces as many as 20 vital service sectors for special focus. While some of the services are traditional, such as tourism and hospitality and retail, many of the focus sectors are new to India and the world, including space services, sports services, and wellness services. India can also be a key partner for emerging services such as facilities management, event and exhibition, urban infrastructure, and environmental services. Many of these services can be delivered from India to offshore locations, helping large cities manage their facilities optimally, facilitating hospitals in maintaining medical records or providing geospatial information. Distinguished participants, excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, the global services trade is far less than the global mercantile trade. However, it has an equal potential given that most economies today are dominated by service sectors in terms of output and employment. Global services trade is, however, challenged by multiple issues relating to legal, economic, or political spheres. Encouraging greater trade in services globally requires us to address policy matters such as access and facilitating through trade negotiations, transparency, dispute resolution, and capacity building. Recognizing the overwhelming role of services trade in the overall trade agenda, India has acted to evolve solutions for dissolving barriers to trade. Accordingly, in March this year, India tabled a paper at the WTO on trade facilitation in services to increase the volume of trade in that sector. I congratulate the Commerce Ministry for this initiative and also this policy paper. Exchange of services represents the way forward to global trade. It's a matter of satisfaction that the third global exhibition on services brings together more than 70 countries, 500 exhibitors to showcase the best products for such exchanges. I would request the industry members present here to leverage the opportunities provided by the many knowledge sessions, sectoral engagements, and international participation to provide an impetus to the trade of services across the board. I am sure that the outcomes of the GES would reverberate positively in future. I wish you all engaging and productive interaction and Godspeed in your endeavors. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Hind.
Honorable Rashtrapati ji, thank you from all of us here, present here collectively. Your presence at this inaugural session is a source of great encouragement to all the participants from India and overseas. Your speech today gives us critical insights on furthering the strengths of the services sector in India. This is not the first time that you are at the GES. We all deeply appreciate this and feel most honored. As you have heard, the GES has grown phenomenally over the last 3 years, and your personal participation twice in a row enhanced the stature of this very significant forum. Thank you once again, sir. Our thanks to the Honorable Commerce and Industry Minister who conceptualized this huge forum and initiated this in 2015. Your leadership has been critical in ensuring that GES become truly global and grow in every aspect, from exhibitors to states' participation and many more relevant sectors as is present today. Madam Minister, our warmest thanks to your highest quality of leadership. Honorable Minister for Communications, Shri Manoj Sinha, we thank you very much for your engagement, and it was great to have had the stamp on GES released here in your presence. Warmest thanks to the host state, UP, and all others participating states. Honorable ministers from UP and Assam has already been with us also in the morning at the site of the exhibition. Thank you, sirs, for being here. Our special thanks to the ministers from overseas who are present here at this function: Uganda, Madagascar, Malawi, Mauritius, Sierra Leone, and the Democratic Republic of Congo who are present here, and many of the other delegates and exhibitors from other parts of the world, which represent the 73 countries participating here. Many of their ambassadors are, of course, present here today. My thanks to all the exhibitors and participants from India also. Finally, a special thanks to our senior government officials from the Ministry of Commerce, the Commerce Secretary, who has been in the leadership, Srimati Rita Tiotia, the Additional Secretary, Mr. Vadhavan, Joint Secretary, Mr. Pandey, and all others from the Ministry of Commerce, SEPC, and CII. Once again, our warmest and sincere thanks to the Honorable Rashtrapatiji for his gracious presence, participation, and hosting the inaugural session of GES 2017. Thank you.